Imagine waking up one morning and deciding not to drink a single drop of water, not even from food or coffee. It sounds impossible, right? Yet this is the start of an extreme biological experiment that few people could survive. The human body, made up of nearly 70% water, begins its silent rebellion the moment hydration stops. At first, you might feel fine, maybe even normal, but deep inside, your cells are sounding alarms. The brain, skin, and kidneys are the first to notice the drought, and within hours, they begin to ration water like a city under siege. What follows is not just thirst. It's a physiological storm. Your blood thickens slightly, your mouth dries, and your energy dips. These are the body's first whispers, subtle, almost ignorable. Yet each passing hour turns those whispers into screams. The clock has started ticking, and the countdown to collapse has begun. By the end of day one, you'll realize that dehydration isn't just about thirst. It's about balance, the fragile harmony between survival and shutdown. And we're only getting started. During the first day, your body enters a mild state of dehydration. Even losing 1 to 2% of water volume can drastically affect performance and mood. Studies show that mental clarity starts fading, headaches emerge, and the urge to drink becomes almost irresistible. Your kidneys quietly reduce urine output, trying to conserve every possible drop. Sweat production decreases, so even if you feel hot, your body struggles to cool itself. This is when fatigue creeps in, a signal that your muscles are already suffering. By the 12th hour, your brain starts to slow electrical communication. Reaction time drops, decision-making becomes foggy, and your mouth feels like sandpaper. The craving for water is no longer psychological. It's biological survival screaming for attention. And here's the scary part. Your body can't store water. Every system, from your blood pressure to your digestion, depends on constant replenishment. Miss it for too long, and you'll start paying the price faster than you imagine. By day two, the consequences intensify. Your body has now entered a defensive mode, redirecting limited fluids to vital organs. Your skin may appear dull, lips cracked, and your tongue heavy. You might even feel dizzy standing up, a sign your blood volume is dropping. Your muscles become less efficient, struggling to generate energy without proper hydration. Lactic acid builds up faster, and your endurance plummets. Imagine trying to walk or even focus at work. Your body feels twice as heavy. Internally, your kidneys are under siege. They're filtering less blood, producing concentrated dark urine. Toxins begin to accumulate. The fatigue you feel is no longer just tiredness. It's your body warning that critical systems are losing equilibrium. If you've ever ignored thirst, thinking it's no big deal, day two is proof that water isn't optional. It's your body's operating system. Without it, everything begins to glitch. The third day is when your brain truly begins to suffer. Neurons depend on water to transmit electrical signals, and with less of it, messages between cells slow dramatically. Concentration becomes almost impossible, and confusion sets in. You might even start hallucinating slightly, as dehydration mimics the effects of sleep deprivation. Your body temperature rises. Without enough water, sweating nearly stops, making internal heat harder to manage. This triggers inflammation and damages brain cells. Studies show that severe dehydration can shrink brain tissue temporarily, affecting memory and emotional control. Your mood changes drastically. Irritability, anxiety, and even mild panic can surface. That's your brain trying to make sense of an emergency it can't fix. Every thought feels heavier, every action slower. By now, dehydration isn't a simple lack of water. It's a full-blown internal crisis. The brain, the organ that controls everything, is losing its rhythm. And the next system to falter? Your heart. On the fourth day, your cardiovascular system takes the hit. With thicker blood and lower volume, your heart must pump harder to deliver oxygen. The result? A rapid, pounding heartbeat even while resting. Blood pressure swings dangerously, and dizziness becomes constant. This overwork strains your heart muscle, especially if you already have cardiovascular issues. The lack of hydration also means less blood returns to the heart, making each beat less efficient. It's like trying to pump sludge through delicate pipes. Meanwhile, your body sacrifices blood flow to less critical areas, like your skin and digestive system, to keep vital organs alive. You might feel cold extremities and even nausea. Your stomach slows digestion to conserve water, creating discomfort and bloating. By the end of day 4, your heart is fighting a losing battle to keep circulation stable. It's doing everything it can to survive, but the drought inside your body is only deepening. By the 5th day, your blood has become noticeably thicker. The reduced plasma volume makes circulation sluggish, and oxygen delivery slows. Your heart, already overworked, now faces more resistance, increasing the risk of fainting or even heart arrhythmia. Each beat is a desperate effort to keep your organs alive. Your cells, starved for hydration, begin to pull water from surrounding tissues. This causes swelling in some areas and shrinkage in others, leading to muscle cramps and spasms. Your skin might feel tight, dry, and almost leathery to the touch. Every movement now takes twice the effort. Internally, your kidneys reach a breaking point. They cannot properly filter waste without enough fluid. Urea and toxins accumulate in your bloodstream, making you feel nauseated, dizzy, and weak. It's a toxic cycle. The less water you have, the more poisoned your body becomes. At this stage, even a small sip of water could bring immense relief. But for someone who continues the experiment, every hour pushes them closer to irreversible organ failure. The blood, once the river of life, is now turning into a slow, deadly current. Your skin, the body's largest organ, starts to scream for hydration. It loses elasticity, becomes rough, and develops small cracks that can lead to infections. Without sweat, your body's cooling system fails and internal temperature spikes dangerously. It's not just discomfort, it's damage. Your eyes become dry and irritated. The tear glands shut down, leaving a burning sensation and blurred vision. Even blinking starts to hurt. Vision problems and sensitivity to light appear, signaling that your brain and optic nerves are now being affected by the dehydration chain reaction. Meanwhile, your digestive organs slow dramatically. The stomach struggles to produce acid, the intestines become sluggish, and constipation takes over. Nutrients are barely absorbed, leaving you weaker by the hour. Every organ in your body is now in emergency mode. What once was a synchronized orchestra has turned into chaos, and the conductor, your brain, is losing control of the symphony. Day 6 marks the beginning of true cellular collapse. Your body starts consuming its own tissues to survive. Cells shrink as water leaves them, and electrolytes become dangerously imbalanced. Sodium and potassium, crucial for nerve and muscle function, spiral out of control. This imbalance triggers confusion, seizures, or even coma in extreme cases. Muscles twitch involuntarily. Your heart rhythm can skip beats. Every cell is desperate for stability but can't function without water as its transport medium. It's like trying to run a city without power or roads. Your organs begin shutting down, one by one. The kidneys fail first, then the liver, as toxins build up faster than the body can handle. The lack of fluid in the bloodstream also leads to a dramatic drop in blood pressure, making it difficult to stay conscious. At this point, your body is no longer fighting to live. It's trying to die slowly and gracefully. It's the last stand before collapse. And yet, one more day remains. When the brain loses water, everything changes. Emotions, thoughts, even identity. Dehydration causes the brain to shrink slightly, pulling away from the skull and triggering headaches. Communication between neurons slows down, and dopamine and serotonin, the chemicals of happiness and motivation, plummet. This leads to mood swings, depression, and a sense of impending doom. decision-making becomes irrational, and the mind may drift into delirium. Some people experience hallucinations of water, rain, or oceans, the brain's last desperate trick to survive. Meanwhile, stress hormones like cortisol skyrocket. The body enters panic mode, flooding your system with adrenaline in an attempt to keep vital functions running. But that surge can only last so long before exhaustion sets in. The human brain is remarkably resilient, but without water, its power fades rapidly. By this point, you're not just thirsty, you're losing the ability to be yourself. By the end of the sixth, moving into the seventh, every major system begins to fail. The kidneys are no longer functioning. The liver can't detoxify. Blood pressure drops so low that oxygen barely reaches your brain and heart. Consciousness starts to fade in and out. Your breathing becomes shallow. The body attempts to conserve its last bits of energy by slowing metabolism. But with no water to transport nutrients or remove waste, each organ suffocates in its own toxins. It's a slow, quiet shutdown. At this point, dehydration isn't a feeling. It's a physical death spiral. The body that once thrived on balance is now collapsing under the weight of its own chemistry. There's no pain sharper than the thirst that can't be quenched. And still, there's one final day, the moment where science meets the limit of human endurance. The seventh day is the edge of human endurance. By now, every heartbeat is fragile, every breath shallow. The body has lost more than 10% of its total water volume, a threshold where survival becomes nearly impossible. Without intravenous fluids, death is only hours away. The brain drifts between consciousness and confusion, thoughts slow, speech becomes slurred, and muscles barely respond. Even the sensation of thirst begins to fade, replaced by a numb calm, a deceptive silence before the end. Your body has accepted what your mind refuses. It can't continue. The skin cracks, lips bleed, and the eyes glaze over. Internally, organs are shutting down one by one. The blood is so thick, it struggles to move, and the heart races one last time before it can't anymore. The body has run out of water, and with it, life. It's a haunting reminder that humans can go weeks without food, but rarely beyond 3 to 7 days without water. In the end, it's not hunger that ends life, it's thirst. Scientific research shows just how delicate our balance with water really is. Losing even 2% of body water affects focus and mood. 5% leads to dizziness and confusion. Beyond 10%, organ failure begins. It's astonishing how something as simple as water defines the boundary between life and death. Experiments with controlled dehydration, performed under medical supervision, confirm that even mild water loss can change blood chemistry and brain volume. MRI scans reveal that dehydrated brains literally shrink, only regaining full size once hydration is restored. It's a visual proof of how deeply water shapes our existence. Physiologists often describe water as the silent organ of the body. It doesn't have a voice, but it sustains every single one. Every chemical reaction in your cells, every electrical signal in your nerves depends on it. When it's gone, everything collapses. So when we say drink more water, it's not a cliche. It's survival advice backed by centuries of biology and modern science. History holds chilling examples of what happens when people are deprived of water. Desert explorers, stranded sailors, and fasting monks have all tested the limits of human endurance. Most didn't survive beyond the seventh day. Their diaries describe the same torment: burning thirst, hallucinations, then eerie calm. In one recorded case, a man lost in the Sahara tried to survive on his own sweat. Within 5 days, he could no longer stand. His last entry spoke of mirages, rivers and lakes that vanished as he crawled toward them. When he was found, his body showed signs of complete organ dehydration.
Even modern survival challenges have shown similar results. Subjects in controlled tests rarely make it past the third or fourth day before needing medical rescue. The human will is powerful, but biology always has the final say. These stories aren't just about death, they're warnings written by those who learned too late how vital every drop truly is. Now tell me, have you ever ignored your thirst for hours or gone a whole day barely drinking water? Comment below if you realize how easy it is to underestimate something so essential. When you understand what happens after 7 days without water, you start to see hydration differently. It's not just a wellness habit, it's the foundation of life. Every cell, every heartbeat, every breath owes its existence to water's invisible power. Drinking water keeps your mind clear, your organs efficient, and your emotions balanced. It's the cheapest, most powerful medicine you'll ever find. And yet, most people live in a constant state of mild dehydration without even realizing it. Every headache, every drop in focus, might be your body's quiet cry for hydration. Science reminds us that the difference between thriving and surviving can be as simple as a glass of water. So next time you drink, remember, you're not just quenching thirst, you're keeping your entire universe alive. If you made it this far, hit like, subscribe, and share this video to remind someone else. Water isn't just part of life, it is life.